Good morning. You and I, we got lots to do today. Welcome to another little vlog. I'm currently on my way to work. Also, it's been really chilly lately in the mornings. Is this Spooktember? October? It's not November yet. I don't know why I'm saying that. But, hi. And for my drive, I'm still slowly but surely chipping away at Homo Deus, the audiobook. I have 2 hours left. Well, 2.5 hours left. We can do this. Or I have a half day of work today, and then I have a lot of errands to run, and I thought it'd be really fun to bring you along with me and just do a quick little vlog. So, got a lot of stuff to do that's on my to-do list today, so I will bring you along with me as I check each item off. These past 3 years, actually, I've been using this special planner called Personal Planner. That's the brand, and I've shown you guys before. You can actually go on personalplanner.com and again, customize your own planner to make it any way that you want. And usually I do like a weekly spread with like my days, kind of like the like vertical columns, but I decided this year to just do a bullet type of journal, and it's been really fun to get creative with the kind of weekly spread that works best for me. Because like, yes, you can plan your own and find like a weekly spread that exactly is what you want, but this year I'm like, I don't even know what kind of weekly spread will work for me because I'm not in school and I'm not really like, I am in school, right? But I'm not in school full time and I have other things that I need to do, so I don't know what my week is gonna look like, so I just decided to try out this bullet journal thing. So that is my little day planner talk, and it's really what helps keep me accountable and productive for my day. So, that being said, I will go on with my day, and then I'll see you after work, my half day, my 4 hours as a registered dietitian. So I just got home and I made myself a nice latte with oat milk, and I even put some, I have this box out because I wanted to show you, the plant-based omega-3. Right now our oceans are really not that great, not very clean. There's a lot of heavy metals in the water, and fish are the literal filters of the ocean. And most of the omega-3 supplements that are on the market right now are made from pressed fish, so it's like the concentrated fish. So there's probably a lot of heavy metals in there. Also, this plant-based omega-3 is in the perfect ratio of long chain and short chain and EPA DHA. I put some droplets in my coffee already, and I like that this is it's a natural lemon flavor, so you don't get that right, like that weird burp up. So here is the nutrition information if you're interested. I am really, really liking this. I've talked often about taking plant-based omegas and their benefit for the brain. They are very, very good for brain, cardiovascular health, joint health, skin especially. So make sure you check it out if you wanna try. So to the planner. Here's the planner, my list of things that I need to do. And this time around, I kind of just made it like personalize myself. So obviously every week I'm gonna have to do my own spread, but I like this because I can make my own like habits right here, everything that I want to do in the days. Actually, ever since starting this, I've started meditating every morning because I want to check it off, and because of this, I've been doing it very consistently for the past couple weeks. So, where is it? Over here, I have my morning journal, and I check when I go to the gym. Oh, for the past 3 weeks, I've been doing a pretty good job. So, let's go back to this week. So far, I have done work, and I still have to laundry and vacuum, and I already soaked and made, or I didn't soak, or I didn't soak the beans yet. My sister soaked them. They're over there in the instant pot. Tomatoes,
No, tomatoes.
Tomatoes. And you picked them where?
In my garden.
Can you show me?
Yeah, let's go.
That's where you got them and you can reach them?
Yeah.
You're so tall already.
That's our turd. And you can pet him. He's very nice. There's a little spider web on him because he's so dirty.
Hi. Let's use our imagination. There's a whole pumpkin patch here, huh?
Mm-hmm. We're actually going to a pumpkin patch.
Alright, I am back in my room. I seem to have gotten this lash thing down, but let me tell you something that I haven't gotten down is this bug bite thing. So right here, this is an ice pack, and this is my ankle because I have so many bug bites on my ankles. I don't know what's going on with the mosquitoes these days, but they are really liking you, girl. This is the tripod, it just didn't fit on the ledge. Anyway, I thought I'd take this time to talk about my planner and just like what's in it, what I put it on it personally, and how it's really helped my productivity and not just planning things like activity by activity every single day, but also like little logs that I put on here too. It's just the magic of bullet journaling, even though I'm no expert and I think that I have a lot to learn and practice on myself. I really am enjoying this. So far on my list, we're gonna look at this together. I did not do physics homework.
So this is my weekly spread. I like to organize it here on the top. This is where I put like the events of the day, what I'm doing. So today I had work for, originally it was 8 hours, but it was 4 hours because I split it with another, one of my coworkers. And I also wrote that it's a full moon today, like I told you guys earlier. And then I just put the events that I'm doing. So I'm not really doing anything especially important on Monday, but I am doing some video work. Like hopefully I can post a video. And I go ahead of time and like kind of schedule my videos and whatnot. This is where I just put a daily things to do. So I'll go around throughout my day or like the day before and I think about the things that I need to get done, or I'm like, oh my gosh, okay, I need to do that tomorrow. If I do not write it down on my planner, then I don't see it. Because I look at my planner like probably 3 times every hour just to cross off things. Like, okay, this is what I just did. What am I gonna move on to next? So today, I have to do my physics homework, which I have not started. I plan on doing that after I go to the gym. I have to go to Best Buy and get a new SD card, but my SD card or my gift card to Best Buy is at home where I need to visit my aunt and my uncle, so I'm gonna do that. I have to do laundry and vacuum still, so I brought the vacuum up. It's outside my door. I am vlogging today. I already made my video go live, which is a yoga flow. I quit my Quizlet subscription for the Quizlet Plus because I originally had it for organic chemistry to help me, but now I'm not taking organic chemistry, so I don't need like the feature with all the pictures and stuff, and I'm sure I can just resubscribe later on. It's not too much money, so. I had to log my CDR, nutrition continuing education credits for my plant-based nutrition certificate, and brainstorm some things for business, and just all of these things, and they go for anything that can pertain to school, to work, to my daily life is what I put on there. And if I have more ideas, I just try to fit it in that rectangle. For me, like, I do things if there's a list that I need to attend to and that I can check off. If there's no list and if I don't put it on my list, then I would probably forget it. A lot of people like to say that they just want to use their phone and log it. And honestly, I tried to do the whole phone thing. But the thing about my phone is I have a love-hate relationship with it. I think it's really useful for communicating and for making content and stuff. But I just feel so much better with a journal that I can actually write in and I feel it, so it's more real to me than just logging it in my phone and putting it away. I do have a lot of notes on my phone, but nothing is more effective in my opinion for productivity for me personally than writing it down on a physical planner. And water. This water tracker has also been a huge game changer because
you may or may not know that my water intake is just not that good when I'm in work, because I sit there and I chart and then all of a sudden it's been 8 hours and I'm like, oh my gosh, I did not drink a lick of water. Well, I got a water bottle and it's like 40 ounces, so it's over a liter. It's like a liter point something, I don't know. But I try to have as much as possible of it, and like logging it has made such a huge difference, because at the end of the day I'm like, oh my gosh, I need to drink more water, or I'll look through my planner and look at all the things that I need to get done and I'll notice that, oh, I didn't drink enough water today. Let me go drink some right now. Which, you know, I really should just naturally drink more water, but I I know I'm not the only person struggling with this. Anyway, that is my little productivity spiel. And one more thing is that I've been using this Jason Cannabis Sativa Seed Oil Moisturizing Cream that you saw earlier for a couple days, and I'm already, it smells so good. I just love the smell of like hemp products. If there's cannabis or like CBD or anything at all or not, it just smells so good to me for some reason. I don't know why I wanted to share that, but I saw it in my closet as I was prepping to talk to you guys, and I just realized that my skin is so dry, so I need it. Shout out Jason for having products like this. This is not sponsored at all. I just thought that this was really cool to share, since I always talk about like cannabis and weed products and CBD and stuff for things other than getting high, because we all know that that's what most people do with weed, but you could also do stuff like this, like calming your external body.
Good morning. It is now the next day. So last night I did not get to finish everything on my to-do list, but I did do meal prep. So that took pretty much the majority of my night. I know some of you have asked me about like showing you the process of my meal prep. So I will show that in another vlog one of these days. But this focus, the focus of this vlog was for my to-do list and productivity and basically how I stay, you know, on track and doing things. But things like yesterday happened where I didn't get to do everything that I wanted. Like, I didn't even go to Best Buy to get the things that I needed. I didn't go to the store. So when that happens, a lot of people are very rigid with their schedule, and I used to be super rigid too, and like very type A, and I wouldn't let myself finish the day unless I finished all of my tasks. But I just allowed myself to finish where I was tired and then defer the things that I had to do. This is something that I learned actually while working in the as a dietitian. But we have to defer patients that we can't see that day because it's just not possible for us to see everybody. So what I do is I defer tasks that I know I can do the next day for the next day as my priority. So taking a look at my to-do list. So the thing that people say about bullet journals is that you can make symbols and just like write them out and know what they mean. So highlight means that I did it, right? And then the arrow means that I'm deferring it to the next day. The X just means not gonna do it, like probably didn't, it just fell through. So I deferred my physics homework because I didn't even start it. I deferred the vacuuming, and so now that is here. Vacuum and physics homework is first, obviously, because I have an appointment or like a STEM tutoring today, and I want to be able to work on my physics homework before I go in and ask questions. And then I have all this stuff to do, and laundry I kind of did, but at the same time I didn't finish it, so I need to put that away right now and then wait for the baby to wake up, because then I can vacuum. And then that would be the end of my, I guess, task list. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this vlog. If you want to try out Personal Planner, make sure you check out the link in the description below. This video was not sponsored. Let me know what your tips for productivity are in the comments below. I'm always open to trying new things, working new systems, always working on trying to refine my own process. So it'll help you as much as like helping other people. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you don't like it, give it a thumbs down. Tell me why you don't like it. Some people thumbs down videos and like they don't give a reason why, but I'd really honestly like to know why. Maybe there's something that could be improved. Anyway, I hope you're having a wonderful morning, noon, day, or night wherever you are, and I'll see you next time. Bye.